From 82, and I have to admit it's one of my favorites actually. I do not know any of their other songs, but I do know this one, and I have absolutely loved it always. So it is in a way pretty easy to play. It has like, well, mainly three chords using shapes in the key of G. They, in acoustic performances, I've seen them do it with a 12 string, which, well, he cannot get the same sound out of a 6 string, obviously, but oh well. From here, I would say half for those chords, your ring finger and little finger here on the 3rd fret of the 2 top strings. Actually, he does the same. So, 4G, and then a C, 4G, you could even leave those 2 fingers on there as well if you would want to, and then for E minor, at one point it does move to that one, and that is actually really it. At one point in the song later, the final chorus, you head into, well, the key change. A whole step up to the key of A. So an A, and a D, and an E, all you need are those 3 chords, so maybe here. I like options for variety, 6 for that matter. As for the capo, in later years I think you do not have to use it. They don't as well. If you want to do it as high as the album version, then of course you need it on the 2nd fret, putting it all in the absolute key of A and then to B. But the shapes we're going to talk about are the ones that I just showed you, regardless of where you put the capo. Now, the progression, it is really straightforward. We will talk about all the usual suspects for that matter. Here and there, maybe a couple of syncopated chord changes, like in particular, I guess, the chorus. There are little things emphasized there, like, you know, things like that, which are nice to incorporate there. Just copying the feel and the rhythm of things you hear on the record, maybe done by the bass or maybe done by the guitar player or, well, and so on. And then as for the strumming, it is definitely in double time. It's a slow song, so you want to have your hand moving at the speed of 16/16s, aka double time. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And I'll break it down a little there, as in things you could do. I also like a little bit of flat picking. They absolutely do so, or do a combination of the two. I tend to do the same, so we talk a little bit about that as well. Now, so actually for an easy-ish song, as in just a couple of chords, a whole step up, then still a couple of chords and you're there. Keep this hand moving and you should be good to go, but there are little things that you can still do. Oh yes, for the intro, it's nice to have it in there. I wanted to kind of do an arrangement of copying the keyboard player, and later I was like, just keep it simple. Anyway, when I'm with you, I would say if you would want to learn it and learn more about the details behind the simple things, then check it out at totallyguitars.com.